a friend of mine sent me a screenshot on WhatsApp about the competition. So yeah, so it's a million shillings. Nikasema, let me try this one, because I've been trying competitions, but as they come through. So I went ahead, I researched, I read articles, kujua what EABL wanted, what the marketing manager wanted. Then I saw they wanted something modern to take them for the next 100 years. So from there, kapiga research yangu. Like at that time, I was not really good at doing logos and design work. I was just doing it for friends. Na side hustle, kubai sapa, hapo kampo. So hivyo, after research, I looked at their former logo. Nikaona they wouldn't want something very different from what they have. So based on that, nika create logo. Nika submit on the last day. Then we had to wait for a week for the top 20 to be announced. I was glad I was one of the 20. Nika check Twitter. They shared for people's sentiments. So I went and read, I saw people's comments. And so the day of the hackathon, I knew what people were looking for. Now, when we went there were experienced creative directors, designers, art directors. So they guided us. We refined the logo. And then maybe 4 or 5 days later, they called. I was expecting the call because the competition, I could gauge myself with the 20 best. So after that hackathon, I knew I must. Kuna vile tu, I top three ningefika. So they called me, they told me I was the winner. I was like, okay. So because the anticipation was what ilikuwa stressful, I couldn't sleep, but at least at that time kulikuwa na La Casa, ilikuwa imetoka season 3, na. So from there, I went for the internship, they sent the money, like that. Learning from people, you see, I had no experience in design. I'm trained as a filmmaker, animator. So yeah, learning from people. I went to 3 different agencies, Ogilvy, Scannard, and Squad. So I learned a lot from these guys. Now, I think the effort that I put is what like made the management, Scannard, they saw something in me. They gave me a job, na tunaendelea kungangana. I think I had overthought it in the beginning. Nilikuwa nimefanya kitu kingine complex, but then just decided let me do something very simple. If you look at the logo, it's so simple, but there's a lot of work that went to it. So that 1 week was working on it, researching and stuff. With the cash, I got machines, I mean computers, graphic tablets, laptops, at least to work. And also if I need help, I just call someone to come, then we work from my machines. Some, of course, you have to send home, Africans. I have to eat well. Nilikuwa kadogo, I've been eating. Yeah, but you keep working, jobs inaendelea kukaa. At least your exposure create a lot of opportunities at your level. So yeah, things changed kabisa for the better. Life improved and stuff. Every day I'm still learning. So far it's been 2 years. I can say I know a lot of stuff. So at least that's what I want to do in the future. But with a lot of experience in doing a cameo, knowledge, so I'm still learning, but for sure I want to pass this to other people. Art is subjective, if it's good enough, if the idea behind it is good enough, just submit it. You never know. Maybe say on the other side, art I perceive differently, could be the best thing. It'll come up. Now I'm very excited and looking forward to kuona wase watafanya nini. At least another person akipata hii experience, it's ni kitu poa sana. So mimi advice to say push, skuma tu, whatever you have, just push it. So for the guys who are designing EABL, the KBL logo, they are very direct on what they want. They want something that will take them for the next 100 years. So try something modern, something in a, it outlive even these 100 years. Maybe wakaenea forever. It can be that good, itako acceptable, something very simple. Nikiona ina evoke emotion, nikiona like it's KBL Kenya, it has to be Kenyan. It should bring out something about us as Kenyans, you see. The colors, just give them meaning. So it's the idea, just push your idea, itakuwa fit kabisa.